Hi there, this is Billy. I want to show you some progress of my 3D designed 3D printed vertical hydroponic tower that can grow plants passively without pump, without electricity. It's just based on the gravitational force. So the tank at the top will store the nutrient, and the nutrient is sent through the central duct to the water level controller, which is a flow valve at each of the tank below. And this will be a passive method that is similar to the Kreki method, only that we fixed the problem of running out of nutrient with the central nutrient reservoir at the top. You can see there are holes at the top cover there. Those holes are for mounting grow lights. So I've designed a new method to use two PVC pipes sliding in and out to adjust the distance between the hanging grow lights and the plants. So I will show you that in this video. Also, I keep modifying my design of the growth tank from the one at the bottom all the way to the one at the top. So I go from 6 plant insert pipe around 160 millimeter big pipe to a 4 plant insert pipes for plants that need longer roots, longer space for the roots to grow. So I raised the PVC pipe a bit higher and reduced the number to 4 per tank. So I'll show you all of this in my video. Thank you. Just an update on my vertical hydroponic tower. That is passive, non-wasting, non-circulating, and everything comes from the top, this nutrient tank. It has two compartments, and it's a central duct that carries the nutrient to each tank. Each tank will have a flow valve. I'll show you this flow valve. So every tank will have a flow valve to control the water level to just 1 inch. And there's a maintenance door. I just redesigned the growth tank with 4 plant insert pipe instead of 6, because that way I can raise the level, the depth of the growth tank, so the plant insert pipe can be raised at a higher level. This will be required for the plants with bigger roots, like the tomato. So we can raise it further if required. There's still an inch space above. I can raise it even further so the roots have more space to hang. For the plants like lettuce or other vegetable that has shorter roots, we can still use the 6 plant insert pipe version, which has a more shallower growth tank. It's only 2 inches for the roots to grow. Next, I'm going to insert this type of PVC pipes to the cover of the nutrient tank, so we can hang some grow lights. Grow lights will be done using this type of PVC pipes. PVC pipes, we have 25 millimeter one and the 20 millimeter one. The 20 millimeter one will slide in and out of the 25 millimeter one, so you can adjust the distance between the grow lights and your plants like this. So you can adjust. Then we'll be able to hang the grow lights over here. So when it's post set up, plug in, it will be like that. This will be how the grow light will be hanged. So you can adjust the distance, making it further like that. And the grow light is just pushing through this hole here. It's quite secure. And there's a cap Where's the cap to close the nutrient tank? Where's the cap? Keep going. Or you can have the gooseneck version of grow lights. You can just fasten the gooseneck M10 screw here, so you can hang the gooseneck. This one is my original design. I haven't seen anyone use it before, sliding the PVC pipe in and out to hang the grow lights. After this elbow joint, so the grow light will be hung from here. The electric cable will be passed through the PVC pipe into this cover, and then the electricity cable will go down the central pipe here, go all the way down to the base. And at the base, we will have a hole drilled so the electric cable will come out through there.